Hello everyone,
we Hello,
are here
guys.
To make the video about the second semifinal of this Eurovision 2018. We are ready, so let's talk about it.
Quindi andiamo a vedere quelli che sono le...
Let's see them. Disclaimer, if we don't like a song, it doesn't mean we don't like that country. We are not judging a country, but we're just saying if we can connect or not with a specific song. So please try to don't feel personally offended. I know it's hard, but please try. We thought that after the first semifinal we wouldn't be angry because almost every song was good. So we could feel sad because maybe our favorites didn't qualify, but great song would have qualified instead of them. In this case, according to us, it's so clear that there are better songs than others. So I think that after this semifinal we will be angry because we are afraid that there will be great songs eliminated. We obviously hope not. And bad song qualified. So we are pretty afraid. I think these are just personal opinions, and if you disagree with us, that's perfectly fine. So let's begin this. Iniziamo.
Sì, vai.
I think we could start just like the previous video with the songs that we both voted for their qualification and we think that they will qualify for sure. And are these four.
E quindi i qualificati in comune che probabilmente passeranno questa semifinale sono. You can see the morning of the weather. Let me up, baby.
Talk about it, about them.
La Norvegia perché? Perché innanzitutto lui mi è molto simpatico e poi mi piaceva il fatto del violino, quindi anche se lui ha già vinto.
He liked the violin, he liked him, he always smiles, he likes his attitude, the song is very catchy, he likes him, his attitude in general.
È molto orecchiabile, molto carina. Forse il testo è un po' così.
Yeah, the lyrics are a bit. So.
Niente di così profondo, però
no,
l'ho apprezzata
deep,
molto e quindi.
But he really appreciated it.
Vai.
Okay, yeah, pretty the same. I want to talk about the Ukraine because I'm not really worried for Ukraine because I see it's very appreciated. But I see that almost everyone just talk about the Ukraine as a good, catchy pop song. And according to me, yeah, it's true. And I'm happy that it's appreciated. But that song is so much more. So I want to invite you to read the lyrics and make your own opinion about that song because according to me it's a waste, it's a shame, it's a pity if you reduce it to just a pop catchy song because it is so much more than that.
Allora, il mio parere sull'Ucraina inizialmente non mi era molto piaciuta perché non è proprio il mio genere.
Not his genre. At the beginning he didn't like it very much.
Ma ha avuto il mio voto.
Okay, then he was really able to connect with this song. So let's say in a poor way. The Denmark, I liked it since the very first listening, so I don't really have a lot to say, so. It's a good song, I always liked it. I think it's a possible winner, nothing else. I like the staging, I like the song, I like the lyrics, I like pretty everything about that song. Danimarca?
No, mi piaceva il messaggio, vai, fai. Wow.
Appreciate
sì,
the message.
Rispecchia abbastanza il mio pensiero filosofico.
And about the Poland, I have to say that it's not my genre, but I appreciate it because I think it's, for what I can know about that genre, that it's a good song, it's well made, so I appreciate it. I really love the message, the lyrics, so I give a lot of importance to the lyrics. So I learned to appreciate that song, it grew in me, not one of my favorite, but it's a good song, and that's why I put it so high.
Concordo con te, bella canzone, ci sta, bella, simpatica, e quindi
a good
andata.
Song. Okay, now we eliminate three songs that we think that actually don't have a lot of chances to qualify. About the Georgia, I want to say that honestly, if I just think of the sound of the song, the melody. I really liked it. It could be one of my favorite, but the lyrics made the difference because the lyrics are, I don't know, I just can't create this connection with that kind of lyrics. I find it trivial. I have the impression that there was not a big effort in writing that lyrics. So it's, I don't know, I found it hard to create a connection with that song, but I have to say that I love the melody, I love the harmony, the voices, the atmosphere is so ethnical, is so typical, and I really loved it. But I just can't ignore when there's something missing in the lyrics, I just can't ignore it.
Sì, diciamo che è un sound molto particolare quello della Georgia, appunto, come già avevo detto, è molto, mi ricorda molto un canto corale di chiesa.
Yeah, sounds so religious to him.
E non è una brutta canzone, però...
Not a bad song.
Insomma, come abbiamo già detto precedentemente, fare una lista è difficile e
purtroppo
alcune sono state penalizzate per delle pecche e forse la Georgia, tra tutte, tra altre canzoni, insomma, questa melodia un po' particolare l'ha un po'
so
penalizzata.
That, No, I repeat, it's a lyric problem to me, not a melody issue. About San Marino, good song, but I don't really like the sentences, and who we are is who we wanna be. I don't really appreciate that sentences. I appreciate the positive message. I like her, Jessica. I completely hate the rapper. I'm not a huge fan of the rap in general, and I think that she... Jenny B really ruined the song. It would be so much better with just Jessica.
Sì, diciamo che potrebbe essere una canzone orecchiabile da radio, però insomma, su questo genere qui tra rap e tutto.
Not a great match. Ecco. Okay. About Montenegro, I think Montenegro doesn't have a bad song. It's just that it's easily forgettable. I mean, every time the song finishes, I don't remember what I've just heard. Now let's continue with the only two countries we disagree, because we agree a lot in this semifinal. Io dico il mio, tu dici il tuo?
Vai.
I gave my qualification and my 3 points to the Sweden.
Mentre io qualifico la Moldova.
I have to say that Sweden is not one of my favorites. It's a good song, it doesn't deserve the last place. You give it the last place. Not my favorite, but it's not that bad. It's a good song, it's catchy, it's good, it's not completely empty. It deserves the qualification, according to me, even though it's not my favorite. The Moldova, it's very funny, I like it, just not enough to qualify.
Qualificata la Moldova perché diciamo che mi piace ogni anno dare una chance a quello che secondo me è un paese un po' debole, e quindi penso che la Moldova era un po' debole quest'anno come canzone, però
yeah,
a me personalmente piaceva.
That, if he thinks that a country is weak one year, I don't know, he has this attitude to think, oh yeah, I want to give you a chance, even though everyone thinks that you're weak, I want to believe in you, and this is the year of...
È comunque una canzone molto simpatica.
But anyway, fine, he thinks that song is funny, is good, and it's not bad, he likes it.
Mentre invece ho penalizzato la Svezia perché mi sembra l'ennesima copia di un Justin Bieber europeo.
Okay, hate the Swedish entry because sounds so the cheap version of Justin Bieber. And he's pretty tired of this kind of
per quanto la canzone
stuff.
Non
the song itself is not that bad, but he's just sick of this cheap version of most famous singers.
Quindi adesso questa volta è il turno dei qualificati in comune, che sono un po' meno peggio rispetto ad altri.
Okay, so these are the our qualifiers we are afraid for. I mean, probably if they were on the first semifinal, I don't think we would have let them pass, but qualify. But considering that they are in this one, we think that this one deserves the qualification, even though they could be unpopular choices, because we eliminated... Our last four eliminated songs are pretty popular, so we are worried. In this case, we have 3 countries with 3 songs, that we may qualify, but we are afraid for them. We are not so sure that they would qualify. And are these 3. Echoes in my head, gotta break the taboo. No, we will never be criminals. Grammy, you say, carpondo e notti e, mi se ne glassi rompa. shortly about the Romania. Romania, I really like the Romania, I have to say, but it created a little dilemma in me between Romania and Poland, because my dilemma was, is it better a song that is my genre but has some mistakes, or is it better a song that is not my genre but well made for what I can know about that genre? And I decided to give my trust to Poland, which is not my genre, but I think it's well made. I like the Romanian entry, I appreciate the message, but I think that I like the fact that the first part was slower, was made to create this sort of hype, to confuse you for a second part more dynamic, so it wants to hit you just in phase, and it works well. But I think that the first part is too long. The problem is that the second part doesn't satisfy the hype of the first part. According to me, they had to make or a shorter first part or a more powerful second part. And I think that the lyrics are a bit trivial. I mean, same thing with Georgia. I don't actually see a big effort in writing that lyrics. So it's... I like very much the sound, I like very much the visible influence to the U2, one of my favorite groups. And so, I'm sorry Bono, I couldn't rank it higher, but I really like very much that song. I have to say that I see it not very appreciated, so I'm a bit afraid that it's not going to qualify, but I obviously vote for Romania.
Appunto, è una bella canzone, però forse appunto l'unica pecca che ha è questa cosa che parte un po' troppo dopo, e quindi... Ripeto, sono proprio bricioline che stiamo guardando.
Yeah, there are details. About Malta, I like Malta's entry. I like the lyrics, I like I like the staging. The staging was very great. And nothing else. I mean, it's a good song.
Bella.
Slovenia is not my genre, but it was the last choice. I eliminated all the others, and so it was just Slovenia, and I say okay. Not one of my favorite, but I give you my trust, Slovenia. I give you my trust, I give you my last point. But please change your dress, because that one looked like a Sugar Glider cosplay.
Bella canzone, lei è una lighting praticamente, direttamente da Final Fantasy 13, direttamente piombata lì sotto.
Oh yeah, it's true. Let's continue. Oh, this is hard. We eliminate two countries. We're not really able to connect with these two songs, but... we see that they are very appreciated, so I think that probably these two countries could qualify. And I mean, nothing against that thing, it's just that I am not really able to connect with these two songs. But I think they are good songs.
E quindi, appunto, questi non qualificati in comune che abbiamo scelto tutti e due sono... Je naši vreme prestaje da žurika, si sa mnom ti.
She's looking at you, I'm falling apart. So about the Serbia, it's just that it's too distant for me. I just can't feel. I think I'm not really into the Balkan sound. During the first listening, I thought it was bad, but then I realized that it's actually just distant for me. So it's I can't make anything. I just feel I'm too far away from this song. But I have to say that I appreciate the fact that it's typical, it's ethnical, it's very particular. So I have to say that if Serbia qualifies, I could be happy. I could agree with that.
Sì, diciamo che forse tra tutte le canzoni è quella un po' più particolare. Sicuramente avrà un messaggio dietro, magari una cosa molto tipica della popolazione serba, però
no,
sì,
I don't like the lyrics.
Distante da altre canzoni, quella un po'
yeah,
meno.
Yeah, but surely we appreciate the fact that it's typical. About Latvia, I like the sound, I really like the sound, believe me. But that lyrics, I can't make it. I'm just not into this kind of lyrics of so... You look at her, she look at you... Please notice me, my worth is nothing without you. It's just no. I really like the sound, but it's distant for me, I think. I mean, it's a cool... It sounds like a cool James Bond soundtrack, but it tells a story that looks like taken from a Dawson's Creek episode. It's just a bad match. I don't like it. I really don't like it. I just can't make it.
Ma secondo me non era male inizialmente, mi era anche piaciuta questa Jessica Rabbit,
panterona lì.
Però appunto, avendo letto il testo, insomma, quello che diceva, sicuramente c'erano testi un po' più che secondo me dovevano passare rispetto a questa canzone qui. Per quanto è una bella canzone,
nel suo genere. Good song.
Magari è una canzone che ascolterai sempre rispetto ad altre, però...
Good song, great melody, rhythm. Miss just the last four songs and we made here a very unpopular choice because, as you can see, I didn't show my first position, so, and it's, I'm afraid it's unpopular because I think it's great, I think it's so clear that it's better than the most of the other songs. According to me, my first four positions should be untouchable, and the fact that my first and third place are in this category, which are the songs that we like very much, we think should qualify for sure, but we are afraid for them, is so frustrating because to me it's so clear that they are better. There's a huge difference between these two songs and the two that we are going to eliminate, but that we are sure that they are going to qualify. There's no way that they're not going to qualify. There's no way that the juries allow to these two countries to not qualify. And we'll show you the first two qualifiers and then the two songs we eliminate. So let's go with the clip. Everybody's got a little long, long when a cold piece high in the black cap is as you can see, the Netherlands. Oh, the Netherlands, I love so much that song. And Hungary too, they are two great entry. And fortunately, Italy can vote that day. So I'm going to give for sure my votes to these two countries because I think they need my vote. I really hope because they're two great songs. I mean, oh, they're so good.
Beh sì, questo country tutto europeo è figo, è...
Such a new combination, country and rock, it's so new, that's new, fresh, and so on.
Ungheria?
Hungary is a great song, what can I say? It's a great song.
È un po' lontano dal mio genere, però avendo visto il testo, insomma...
I think he was influenced by me and my enthusiasm, but... Cioè, penso di averti influenzato un po' io e il mio entusiasmo.
No, diciamo che anche il testo ha influito un po', perché appunto è totalmente un genere che...
The lyrics did happen that changed our mind. But why did we eliminate Australia and Russia? Russia, I think it's not a bad song. It's just so powerful to deserve the qualification.
Io l'ho già detto, personalmente preferivo la canzone dell'anno scorso.
He preferred the last year entry. No, it's better this one. It's just still not enough. But obviously, there's no way it's not going to qualify. There's no way. I don't like the fact that in this song I see some cutting remarks against the disqualification of the last year, and I'm not really a huge fan of this kind of stuff in a song that participated in a competition in the Eurovision. And it's not the first time that Russia puts a cutting remark in song.
Tanto passerà di sicuro.
Tanto passerà di sicuro, ma Australia is not bad, but just again the lyrics are so trivial. I mean, the first part, the verses, I really love them. I was so okay, girl, I'm following you. I know you want me to follow you, so I'm following you. Verses are really good. I like her voice, the attitude, the positive energy. But then the chorus comes, and I was so. My reaction was I was so happy. I was, yes, girl. Oh, yeah. What's your answer? We make the same mistakes. We pretend to be someone else. No, I know what you must be thinking. We're powerless to change things. Yes, girl. What's your answer? And then, don't worry because we got love. I mean, really. Seriously, is that your answer?
A me personalmente è piaciuta come canzone e non vado a vedere questa sottigliezza dell'amore. Secondo me è carina come canzone.
Yeah, it's nice, but it's just...
Vabbè.
All the enthusiasm I had was lost, so no, flew away. No.
Non era male invece la storia, però altre scelte l'hanno fatta essere...
Yeah, he eliminated that song just because compared to the others, it's... I guess, still non è ancora abbastanza rispetto alle altre, no? Not
sì,
bad,
no,
but
certo,
still
certo.
Not... Okay. So, this was our opinion. No, according to me, between Netherlands and Australia, there's such a huge difference. I mean, you don't see that there's a huge difference. I think we will never have something in common. And you could think that it's a luck, but believe me, it's the feeling is reciprocal. Just love the Netherlands entry this year, and Hungary too. I feel also frustrated because according to me, Austria and Russia qualify for sure. That's frustrating. That's frustrating because I'm gonna be so angry if Russia qualifies, for example, and the Netherlands not. I would feel so angry. Let us know your opinion in the comments. We wish you a pleasant Easter. Oh, let us know what you do for Easter. We are going to Sofia.
E noi sì, insomma, ce ne andiamo a Sofia per Pasqua. Quindi buona Pasqua a tutti.
See you to the next video. Gotta go. So, ciao.
Ciao.